Good day, Ed here from Regroove. Today I want to share a little bit of tips and tricks on how to copy a site page from one SharePoint site to another using Power Automate. So basically, in this scenario, I have two sites, which is first the I Love Cat site and then the I Love Dog site. So what I want to do is I want to copy this Cat Lunch Buddy page, this whole page to the I Love Dogs page. And why I want to do this using Power Automate is I don't want to waste my time basically on the new page to create a new template, to get the photos, to get the text. I want this whole templated page to be on the I Love Dogs page. And then basically once it's in the I Love Dogs page, I can quickly edit it and to my liking. So to do that, we use a tool called Power Automate. To give you a Microsoft description of what Power Automate is, per Microsoft, Power Automate is a service that helps you create automated workflows between your favorite apps and services to synchronize files, get notifications, and collect data and more. So basically, it's a tool that helps you automate your business workflow. I love it because it makes my life easier and faster. So the first step to do this automation would to go to the your source site, which is in this scenario the I Love Cat site. And what I want to do in my source site is to go to my settings cog, and then we go to site contents. And then once we're in the site contents, we want to go to the site pages. So remember, the purpose of this automation is to copy Cat Lunch Buddy, which is found in the I Love Cats page, to the I Love Dogs page here. So on the I Love Cats page, we go to site pages and we go create our flow, like a Power Automate flow. So to do that, we go automate, Power Automate, and create a flow. So it will give you a pop-up icon here, and then go choose see your flows. It will take you to the Power Automate workspace. In this scenario, I want to create a workflow. I'm gonna create an automated workflow. So we'll give the flow a name, cat to dog site flow. And then we'll give the cat to dog site flow. And then we'll create our first action for that particular flow. So what I want to do is my first action is to tell Power Automate where to get the page or get the item, which is the Cat Lunch Buddy page. So to do that, I'm going to search for selected item. And then, of course, it's a SharePoint. It's from SharePoint, so we pick SharePoint. And for the site address, we're going to go to the drop-down menu. And on the drop-down menu, it will show you the sites in your tenancy. In this case, the source site would be I Love Cats. And the list name. So to get the list or the where the site page is or the site page ID, we'd have to go to we have to press enter custom value. We'd have to go to the source site. We'd have to go to settings and library settings. And then once we're on the library settings, we go to the navigation bar on top and copy everything after list equals. So in this scenario, we copy everything from percentage 7B to percentage 7D. Copy. And then I'm going to paste it here. So once you've pasted that item ID, I would just delete percentage 7B and percentage 7D, because the most important thing is this basically item ID that tells Power Automate what item ID is cat, the name of the cat lunch buddy's item ID, which is this one. So we have to copy this one. And then after that, we want to name this basically trigger. So we name it as a site URL. And then that's your first step. That's your trigger. It tells Power Automate where to get the item. Second step would be to tell Power Automate what item to get. So in this scenario, we pressed new step. And then I'm going to search for get item. And then get item from SharePoint. And then same thing, site address would be from your source destination. List name would be the page ID for cat lunch buddy, which is that, starts with C. And then the ID identification for it is basically the file identifier. And that's your second step. Save that. So to recap, what we did is we created a flow. First step on that flow is we tell Power Automate where to get the item. And then second step is what item to get. And then third step would be to get the item's file properties. So how we do that is we go next step again, new step. And then we go get file properties. And then, of course, from SharePoint, same thing, source site, library name, which will be the same thing. Enter custom value and then paste that. And then ID would be same thing for a selected item. It's that identifier. And then we'll save it. So to recap, our flow has three steps now. First step is to tell Power Automate where to get the item. Second is to tell Power Automate what item to get. And then third is to tell Power Automate to get that item's file properties. And we have the fourth and final step, which is to copy the file from one site to another, which in this scenario, we go next new step. And we go search for copy file. So copy file in SharePoint. So as you can see, there are different options and drop-down menus here. This basically tells us current site address would be from the source site, Isle of Cats. We want to copy the page called cat lunch buddy. So where that folder is located is choose the folder, and then we go to site pages. And in this scenario, already saved it as a template. So we go templates, and the cat buddy page is here. And then the second step in this particular fourth step is to tell Power Automate where you want to copy that item to. So in this scenario, the destination site, which is the Isle of Dogs site. Isle of Dogs, and we go destination folder. We can go just site pages, or you can just search from here in this folder. And then for this question. If another file is already there, we just go copy with a new name, and then you press save. So now it's saving. So once this is saved, our Power Automate flow is complete. Our flow to copy from one, to copy the Cat Lunch Buddy page from the Isle of Cats site to the Isle of Dogs site. So to recap, we have four flows. First flow is to tell, we have four steps in one flow. So the steps in this particular flow is, first step is to tell Power Automate where to get the item. Second is to tell Power Automate to get that particular item. Third is to tell Power Automate to get that the file properties for that item. And then third is basically to the action to copy that site page from one site to the other. And that completes our Power Automate flow. And then make sure to save. So once we've created our flow, we have to ensure that it works. So we have to test it. And to activate that flow, we go to the source site, Isle of Cats. We go to pages. We pick that particular item that we want to copy. And in this scenario, it's on templates and Cat Lunch Buddy page. We go select that item. We go to automate. And as you can see, this is the flow that we created, cat to dog site flow. You press that. It will tell you to run the flow. So continue. It will ask you where you want to copy that flow to run that flow, your input. So in this case, the Isle of Dogs site, I'll copy their site URL, paste it, and then run it. So it's complete. The flow is running, and now it's on the Isle of Dogs page. So if to check that, we go to pages, and then it's here, Cat Lunch Buddy. And then everything is saved here in our new site, which is our dog site. Also, if you want to save it as a template in the new site, what you do is you go press edit, then you go save as a template, and then you have to name it dog, and then save page as a template. So to check if it's already a template, we go pages, and then as you can see, we have a new folder called templates, and then basically that is the Dog Lunch Buddy template. So to recap, what we did is I taught you how to copy a site page from one SharePoint Online site to another using Power Automate. Why this is important is it will save you time. It will connect all your workflows together. And basically, you'll have more time to do other stuff and to be productive. That's it for me, Ed from Regroove. Thank you for your time, and we'll see you again. Bye.